So I'm going to be talking about how to build a SharePoint Learning Hub. This is a mock-up that I did for the 2025 SharePoint Hackathon, and I'm really excited to hear that it's coming back in 2026.
Did we lose you, Pete? Did you accidentally get muted?
I think I accidentally got muted there. Can you hear me all right?
Yep, you're back.
Perfect. Alrighty, so my name is Pete. I'm a business applications architect for a company called Omni Workspace. It's not a tech company. We actually design interiors. So I technically manage the Microsoft Modern Workplace for a company that designs workplaces. Outside of that, I'm a regional leader for the MGCI, which is the Microsoft Global Community Initiative. We help volunteer and organize a bunch of free community events across the globe. One of those events and groups that I help manage is actually the Minnesota Microsoft 365 user group. So if you've ever tuned into our calls, I'm the man behind the curtain, sending out all the emails, the announcements and everything. You can find me at Simpkins Pete across all the socials, though I'm most active down there at LinkedIn. So I'm going to quickly run through my site, talk a little bit about how we manage content within the site for learning information, as well as some highlights for the resource pages on the site itself. And then lastly, I'd really like to highlight the agent support that we actually built into the site for the hackathon. So my goal with building out this site was really to help highlight how SharePoint can make it really easy for companies or groups to manage their learning content. And more importantly, I'm going to help highlight this as kind of a small to mid-sized business approach. So this could be presented as a centralized learning hub, though it also applies really well for departmental roles, user groups. It also works really, really well for project or change management. So I'm actually kicking off a really big project with ERP stuff. It's likely that we'll end up doing a lot with this kind of concept to help support that whole business process change. Now, the other feature or part of this that I wanted to emphasize is, as I was building this out, I really wanted to use just the standardized SharePoint web parts. I promise I'll bake in some SPFX into next year's hackathon. But for this case, I really wanted to use a lot of this, the new announcements, the new features, as well as kind of enhance it with a couple Power Automate flows, and then obviously with Copilot too. So let's jump over into our site. I'm going to change which screen I'm sharing. Perfect. So this is the site that I built out. We're on the homepage right now. So I really wanted to emphasize or highlight some recent learning content. I've really enjoyed using the new carousel web part for this hero web part to help highlight maybe some of the key or most frequently used learning resources. So in this case, you'll see that we have just some general announcements around like what the site might look like, what's the purpose of it, and so on. I also don't ever want to be the only person to create content. So I always leave a call for speakers open for anyone across the organization to come out and actually submit here. We'll come back to that agent section there. But I also like to highlight and surface news posts. One of my favorite things as I lead training sessions or as I attend stuff is to go back and actually capture that information, post the recording back out, and share that via news in SharePoint. So you'll see that we have a handful of news posts down here at the bottom that we help emphasize. And then over on the right-hand side, I always like to highlight what's coming up in the future. So what are some upcoming learning events across the organization? Maybe we want to talk about team communication for our SharePoint owners or so on, maybe some new UI features or so on. As we get into content management, let me get over to the learning documents. You're going to see maybe a little bit behind the curtain, but in this case, I'm showing this business hasn't fully adopted the metadata only, so there are still folders. But as we click into the resources themselves, I want to highlight a couple things that we are pushing through here. You'll notice that I have columns here to help capture some of the key information about those files. So in this case, we're helping emphasize maybe what phase or part this project document relates to. We've created some columns here to help emphasize maybe what the roles that this document applies for, as well as maybe what tools or applications that it references. And those will come into play here as in a little bit as we start to talk through the resource pages, as well as some of the views for the diagrams. Just from a general governance standpoint, this is something that I really love to put into place for a lot of my sites for learning, is I really like to identify who actually owns the document. So who's responsible for maintaining the information, as well as identifying maybe who reviewed it last for relevancy, as well as what was the date. Now, as we start to talk through some of the Power Automate functionality that I like to build out or things that you can help do, I always like to make an option where a user can actually go out and maybe flag a document as requiring review. So simple ways to do that is you could just have a manually triggered flow like this. Obviously, you could also add a button into a column if you wanted to do some more advanced kind of column management. But in this case, if I wanted to say maybe request that this one launches, what should happen is it should open up a little window and allow you to prompt, say, hey, why does this document maybe need a review? And it'll go through and it'll actually change the status of that document to pending review, as well as map the information into the notes column. And then even better yet, it'll actually alert the individuals that are highlighted in that content owner and reviewed by column. So really good process just to help make sure that your process documentation, your training documentation is not only being maintained, but if there are any flags, right, that you have a way to actually get them updated. Additionally here, we use those columns also to help highlight some of the views. So you'll notice that we build out views, maybe specific to the roles that filter down. So maybe I only want to see the files that are related to the salesperson or designer or so on. You can have those right here, though we'll build them into what I'll cover next, which is our role pages. So the other thing that I really like to do is to take that metadata and actually pull it into and make it more useful at the site level. So if I have a designer that wanted to come out to the site and learn and see all of their information, they can just come out to this role page. In this case, it's going to help serve up that view within the document library so that they can interact with maybe just the documents that they need to reference. In this case, I am helping highlight some of the functionality of being able to use the group by functionality with metadata, make it a little more useful over here on the left-hand side. This also provides a nice opportunity to surface some additional links, maybe even link out to a community. So in this case, we have communities built for a lot of our roles so that they can go and ask questions. In this case, maybe it's a follow-up around what kind of manufacturer should they be working with for something. We also carry that same content all the way through into SharePoint or into the app pages. So this is another good way to kind of work your way through the tools and resources that you're working in. So being able to help go out and highlight maybe what is the tool, who owns it, or who are the subject matter experts, as well as surfacing relevant documents, again, from that document library that were tagged appropriately, as well as highlighting maybe some news and announcements. So those same metadata columns that we looked at around maybe the roles, the applications, we actually apply those into our site page library as well. So that's what you're seeing over here. These are all the news posts that relate to SharePoint. Additional resources. These are always things that I feel like people miss. I always encourage you to go out and make sure that you capture information about maybe what's the site purpose, right? Who owns it? Who has access to it? And additionally, in this case, a lot of this is around document management. So maybe what are the processes around the tagging of the information? What types of values? Maybe what views are out there? So building this out is additional resources too. And then lastly, one of my favorite features is we actually built in an agent. A lot of our companies are named after space kind of theme. So you hear Omni Workspace, Atmosphere, Mezzo. So I had a little bit of fun here with our agent and named him Astro. But the idea here was that we wanted to be able to create an agent that anyone could go out and they could actually ask a question. I find, especially with learning content, a lot of folks don't want to necessarily feel like they highlight that they don't know how to do something, right? So an agent's really good at helping kind of break down that question kind of fear. So if I wanted to come out here and I say, maybe how do I print a quote? Maybe it's something that I don't do very frequently. This will actually go out and take a look at all of our training and how-to documents that are in the site, and should come back and provide not just the response, but also will link back to the training documentation. Other prompts or responses that we can do here is if you needed to help find maybe who's the owner of that content and who last updated it. I've noticed that Astro is really good at helping pull that back. And all of this, you'll see great options here. Apparently, there's multiple ways that we can quote across our organization. If I get into the editing for that agent, for sources, we've just grounded it just in this entire site. So this does pull information from everywhere. For the behavior, it was pretty simple. So all I wanted it to do was provide helpful and accurate information while making it fun and engaging. I also did ask that the responses should sound like an astronaut space explorer. So really wanted to dive into that theme, have a little bit of fun there. That's all that I have for today.